Hi, John Tisbury here. We've had our Tesla Powerwall 2 installed on the 4th of December 2018. Today it's Monday the 18th of February 2019, which means we've had the Powerwall installed for 76 days. I was planning to wait till early March to do a full sort of 3 month review, as it were, but I couldn't wait, so I thought I'd do it today. So this video is about some of the highs and lows of the Tesla Powerwall 2 performance over those 76 days. So let's run the intro and I'll see you after the break. So welcome back. As I mentioned in the introduction, we've had our Tesla Powerwall installed for 76 days. And what I wanted to do was just take you through the performance, the sort of some of the key highs and lows over that time period. If you're a new viewer or haven't tuned into any of the previous Tesla Powerwall videos that I've done, let me just give you a little bit of information about our setup so you can put things into context and compare apples with apples, as it were. We're based in the UK. We're in the Midlands, or in the East Midlands to be more exact. We have a 4 kilowatt PV installation, solar installation, which has 16 Sanyo solar panels, and it's connected to a Sunny Boy 3.8 kilowatt inverter. The solar was installed quite some time ago. It was installed in September 2011, and you know, it's been going great. And we had that installation before the sort of advent of the smartphone, which meant that we didn't have any sort of smart app interfaces or any way of monitoring the solar generation, how much we actually generated each day. The only thing we have got to measure that is a meter in the utility room, which is an incremental accumulative meter, which shows the amount of kilowatt hours our solar array has produced since the dawn of time, as it were. And because we didn't have any other measures, what I did from day one, for almost eight years, at the end of each solar generation day, when it got dark, I wrote down and recorded in a spreadsheet how many kilowatt hours we had produced that particular day. Things have changed now, thankfully, with the Tesla Powerwall, because we now have the app, which allows me to monitor the usage in the house and what's been generated on the solar panels. So it can all be done either on the computer or on my mobile phone, my smartphone, and record those details. I do actually still keep my spreadsheet running, and that's really what I'm going to take through in a minute, show you some of the graphs and some of the performance stats over the 76 days. It's, as I was saying in the intro, sort of comparing oranges with oranges. As we've only had the installation for 76 days, I can't compare year on year at the moment. But that will come with time once we've built up a bit more data. So let's have a look at the highs. One of the most exciting highs was actually on Valentine's Day, February the 14th. And it wasn't romantic at all, in fairness, but it was an achievement, because it was the first time since we've had the installation that the Powerwall managed 100% charge. We've been close up till then to about 71%. That was the maximum we ever achieved during a day. But 14th of Feb was 100% charge. And that meant the next day we were in a really good position, because we used some of the power overnight and in the early morning from the Powerwall. But by the end of the following day, the 15th of February, we'd achieved our first ever 100% self-powered day, which meant that the solar and the battery pack both combined to provide power to power all our needs, and we didn't need any power from the grid. Hooray! So, perfect. Absolutely perfect. And that particular day, just in case you're wondering, do we turn everything off and use no power at all, just to conserve the battery, we acted as normal. And we actually consumed 27.4 kilowatt hours during that day, the 15th of February. Just to give you some context on that, generally our rolling average since day one I've been recording our usage is about 25.5 kilowatt hours. So we were slightly above average usage by a couple of kilowatts. I was so excited about it, obviously told it to my wife, and also burst onto Twitter to inform the nation, the world, that we'd done 100% self-power, which was good. Oh yeah, it's worth noting that it's obviously the middle of winter here as well, so we're in February, so we're coming towards spring, coming to the spring equinox in March, middle of March, or end of March, 21st, 22nd, something like that. So we're slowly finding that the daylight is drawing out, getting more daylight per day. So how has the Powerwall done to date since the installation over those 76 days? Well, in terms of our self-power, it's contributed 12% to our overall total of self-power generation. So from the 4th of December to date, we've averaged 29% self-power between the solar and the Tesla working side by side, which, as I said, is the winter here at the moment. Which means short days, long nights, lots of power usage, lots of lights. So more electricity is consumed during the winter than during the summer, obviously. And it means you've also got less time to produce solar power because the days are shorter and the sun is on a very low arc. So it's not as intensive as it would be. Thankfully, with our positioning with our solar panels, we're not overlooked. We don't have any trees or anything to mask the sun during its trajectory. So we do benefit if the sun's up and shining. We will benefit from it all day, even when it's on a low arc across the sky, which is nice. So there the highs are 100% self-power and 100% Powerwall for the first time, total charge, and our 29% rolling average of self-power over that 76 days. Some of the lows that I was also mentioned about in the introduction, thankfully there's not too many. I noted over those 76 days that we had 20 days where we generated less than 1.8 kilowatt hours in a day from the solar panels. And actually 7 of those days we generated less than a kilowatt. And that was, those sort of 20 day period was all in December. So December must have been very grey and overcast and dull. A really gloomy month. So let's have a look at some of these figures. I'm bringing them up on spreadsheets as we work our way through. This particular chart is showing you the average daily solar generation and the monthly total solar generation, and this is running from July 2017, and I've obviously got data right back to 2011, but didn't really want to bore you with that. My interest really is in the last 3 months, so the December 2018, Jan 2019 and Feb 2019 to date. And from this chart you can see that our average daily solar generation is going up month on month. In December it was a very pitiful 4 kilowatt hours on average a day. We're now up to 9.6. We have had some super days, actually a couple of really nice days where we've achieved good solar power. This chart below it, there you go, shows the percentage of solar contribution and Powerwall contribution to our overall self-power contribution, if that makes sense. So in December, 5% was solar, 12% was Powerwall, January was 11% and 16% respectively, and today in February, 20% of our self-power is solar and 23% is Powerwall. And you see those figures are going up month on month, so it'd be interesting to see what those are like at the end of February and then moving in towards the summer months. I'm hoping for quite a few months of 100% self-power generation, where as at the moment we're not quite there, but heading that way. So this particular chart is tracking our average monthly kilowatt hours of usage over that month by day, so the average daily, I guess, is the easy way of saying it. And if you look at the first column there, which is December 2018, we used on average on a day 25.4 kilowatt hours, and 22 of those were supplied by the grid, and that's the line that's tracking below. And in January, we used 24.9 kilowatts on average on a daily basis, and we had 19.8 kilowatt hours supplied by the grid. So you'll notice a slight drop of that bottom figure and that bottom line as it tracks away from the line above, and that's really what we're looking to see, is our reliance on the grid reduces. So the amount of power we're pulling from the grid also reduces, so that line tracks downwards. And in February, remember we're on the 18th of February today, so we're still not at the end of February, so it's not a complete month. We've used on average on a daily basis 26.8 kilowatt hours. We've had a few cold snaps during that month of February. However, we have used less from the grid at 18.4 kilowatts, and we should see that continue to track and drop away. And this final grid I wanted to chat to you about, final chart, sorry, I've got grids on the mind. This final chart is our income in terms of our feed-in tariff. Because we had ours back in 2011, we benefited from the very high feed-in tariff of 52 pence per kilowatt hour feed-in tariff. And this is our average feed-in tariff income on a yearly basis over the last 7 years. So it averages around sort of £2,100 a year income from the feed-in tariff. And the other chart on the right there shows the annual generation, the annual amount of kilowatt hours that we've generated from solar. So that's all my charts, that's all my data. I hope you found that useful, the summary of how things have gone, the highs and lows of the Powerwall installation for the last 76 days. If you've got some comments, got some thoughts, some ideas, then please drop them in the comments section down below. Always like reading people's comments and thoughts, suggestions. And thumbs up, thumbs down, again, is always really useful to help the visibility of the channel and help the channel grow. If you like the content, then again, perhaps consider subscribing, because that's always appreciated too. Anyway, see you on the next one. So take care. Bye.